wants to pin me down to one or two, you know. No, it's mixed tribes. And I'll tell you why they were so mixed. Hispanized Indians. In 1776, explorers Fray Francisco Atencio Dominguez and Fray Silvestre Velaz de Escalante visited here. In 1830, the settlement became one of the stops on the Spanish Trail, which linked Santa Fe with Los Angeles, California. See, the old Spanish Trail used to go through all these little villages. But when they started building the new highways, they missed us. Like here, they went down below, you know,
uh-huh.
the straight as they could. And the entrance is coming up to the village and going up through the village and down and down. And then you would join again the main route. But and that's the way they done in a lot of other villages. But that's the way they done here in Abigail. You heard me read it, right?
Oh, yeah,
you read
it. Oh, yeah.
Okay. This turned out to be, a long time ago, it was a trading pueblo, selling slaves. So I heard they sell slaves, you know. Girls were very valuable because there wasn't any, you know. When the first Spaniards came, they didn't bring any woman of their own. So they had to go steal the Indian girls from the Indians and brought them. And then they started growing, and then more Indians coming and getting mixed up, and that's where we got mixed up with Genizaro and the Spaniards. And when we became the United States, they didn't want to recognize us as a tribe because we were too mixed, they said. We were too mixed. We didn't know what we were. We sealed off.
What about the Genizaros blazing the old Spanish trail?
I don't know if you can give the Genizaros that credit.
Well, according to several different publications, mm-hmm. that the Navajos, Apaches, Utes literally blazed it, but you couldn't really trust if you were Spanish. You certainly couldn't trust the Ute, Apache, or Navajo to guide you along the trail.
Oh.
That the only trustworthy guides were Genizaros from the village of Abiquiu.
Well, that sounds good.
So that
sounds
right, because
that sounds good.
The trails were here. The Indians had the trails. Then when the Spaniards came and all that, they followed the same trails that the Indians had. That's how they long places, but they use the same trails.
And mm-hmm. see, this Abiquiu was really the start.
Yes.
Of
the old Spanish trail. Down by the, not by the river, but on 84, up closer to Trujillo's, is Rosa de Lima?
Rosa de Lima, the ruins of the church.
Was that the original?
That was the original.
And they
church.
Moved up here in 1770?
Yes.
There's two levels there, because that the Spanish tried to settle there first. Because this was always had Indians living, you know. And so the Spanish tried to settle down there, and that was their church. That's where Rosa de Lima, down there. And several times the nomadic Indians would raid them, and they would run Santa Fe. Established for that reason. But the Spaniards, so there were actually two churches at one time.
Mm.
But the Spaniards kept being raided down there, so eventually they moved up.
And I guide tours three ways. I guide them by map,
mm-hmm.
which is the most popular one, or I go with them, or I take them myself. Mm-hmm. And believe me, some tourists want me to take them and show them these nice places, you know, that we have. Because we do have nice hiking places like the White Cliffs across over there, directly north. We have the White Place, the White Cliff, and then little kids. You all know what it is, right? It's the little round ones that go on top of the beaches. Top of the beaches, that you see one way and one way and the other like that. That's right. It's silly. Tanner, a good old man with us, and in the evening we used to go there and he gave us 25 pennies. And we were very happy with our 25 pennies that he paid us every day so we could come and build. And the rest of our rooms.
What are the penitentes?
We are laymen of the Catholic Church, and this order was brought from Spain, with the Spaniards that came, and with the priests that didn't have enough priests to take care of the people, because there was one priest for thousands of people, I guess. Then, and so the brothers are helpers, laymen of the Catholic Church, of the priest. We take over when the priest does his blessings and everything he can do. Then we take over, because he can take care of everything, you know, himself. He's only one man, and he has six missions besides the Abbey Q Church. He has six more missions that he has to take care of. And that's where we come in, to pray the rosaries, to bury the dead, to sing the alabados, which I'm an alabado singer, and I have some at home and recorded, and we just take over and help him do what he cannot get up to do it, because like a few weeks ago he had a wedding going on Saturday, and two dead men, and five baptisms or confirmations that he had to do that same day. Our dwelling place, our little chapel for us, the Brothers of the Light. I'm an helper of the Brothers of the Light, and every year during Lent, all the whole month of Lent, we're active, praying the rosary, the stations of the cross, and everything at either here or in the church, in the main church. But then during Holy Week, which was last week, more active every day. And we have brothers that come from other little villages that belong with us here, and they stay here. We have a place for them to stay here, and they stay all week here. And the people, our local people, feed them. They love to bring food and feed them, you know. They fight, families, the wives fight to have that day. They want Friday, or they want Thursday, or Monday, or Tuesday, you know. They fight. Of course, everybody wants Friday and Saturday, or something like that. More special day. Where I used to work for her, and she lived 40 years here with us, and I worked with her off and on all these 40 years since I was a little kid. Since I was a little kid, I worked here with her, you know, and so. But this is her house, and this is where I worked with her so many years. I'm one of the oldest in Abiquiu, one of the elders that worked the most, I think, with her, you know, one of her chauffeurs, one of her all-around men, one of fixer-uppers and gardener and you name it. We planted those green, I think I told you, we planted those trees. But all this was...
The thing about this place is there's no history.
Her paintings and movies. They make movies here all the time too. And people that come and paint and take pictures.
You know, they told us that